You may have heard before that the electric force is very strong compared to the gravitational force. In this video, we're going to illustrate exactly what that means by computing the electric and gravitational forces between the proton and electron in a hydrogen atom. So in our picture, we have the basic Bohr model of the hydrogen atom. So we have an electron orbiting around a proton at a distance of A0, which is called the Bohr radius. And that serves as a good approximation of the separation distance between the proton and the electron. We're given all the constants we need in a table. So that starts with the Bohr radius, then we're given the mass of the proton, the mass of the electron, the elementary charge E, and note there that the charge on the proton is plus E, or plus 1.6 times 10 to the negative 19 coulombs, and the charge on the electron is minus E. And those opposite charges give us an attractive force between the proton and electron. And finally, we're given both the gravitational constant, big G, and Coulomb's constant, K. So first, we'll get the gravitational force between these two particles. And to get this done, we use Newton's law of gravitation. It says the force of gravity between two masses is given by G times the product of the two masses divided by the distance between them squared. So now we just have to plug all these numbers into Newton's law of gravitation. And I went ahead and kept units on all those numbers so we can see how the cancellations occur. I have two factors of kilograms in this denominator, and then a factor of kilograms here for the mass of the proton and here for the mass of the electron. Then I have two factors of meters in my numerator for the units on big G, and those are going to cancel the two factors of meters in the denominator from squaring the radius. This leaves us with units of newtons. And when I run the numbers on this to three significant digits, I get 3.63 times 10 to the negative 47 newtons. Okay, so there's the gravitational force between the proton and the electron. Now let's do the electric force. To get this done, we have to use Coulomb's law. And Coulomb's law says that the electric force is given by K Q1 Q2 over R squared, where K is Coulomb's constant, Q1 and Q2 are the two charges that are interacting, and R is the separation distance between them. So again, we just need to plug everything in. And notice in the numerator here that each of these particles has the same magnitude of charge. It's 1.6 times 10 to the negative 19 coulombs. We're also computing a magnitude of this force, so we're not concerned with the fact that the charge is negative on the electron and positive on the proton. So we're going to get two copies of that factor of 1.6 times 10 to the negative 19, so I can just write that more compactly by putting an exponent of 2 on it. And there's our Bohr radius, and we're going to square that as well. Again, we can keep track of the units here. I have two factors of meters in this numerator, and those are going to cancel the meters in the denominator after we square them. I have two factors of coulombs in my denominator, canceling two factors of coulombs in the numerator after we square that 1.6 times 10 to the negative 19 coulombs. So again, our units come out to newtons. And when we run the numbers on this to three significant digits, we get 8.22 times 10 to the negative 8th newtons. So there's the electric force, and we can tell this is a way bigger quantity because that negative exponent is a lot smaller. But what's the best way to answer this question of how much stronger is the electric force? And I think the most natural way to answer this is to take a ratio of the two forces. So we're going to take the electric force and divide that by the gravitational force. And this tells us how many times bigger the electric force is compared to the gravitational force. So our electric force was 8.22 times 10 to the negative 8 newtons. Our gravitational force was 3.63 times 10 to the negative 47 newtons. And when we run the numbers on this to three significant digits, we get 2.26 times 10 to the 39. So it turns out the electric force is radically bigger than the gravitational force in the hydrogen atom, exceeding the gravitational force by 39 orders of magnitude. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left. Or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.